This is in Nubra Valley in Ladakh. This is a moonrise over the Indus River, again in Ladakh. You know, all these are things that I would not have discovered if I was not traveling India by road. That's near Shoja in the Gushani Valley. That's a rainbow, a place called Raju's Cottage. This is on the road to Kibitu. When I was doing this Himalayan drive, the final destination was a place called Kibitu, which is supposedly the easternmost motorable point in India. And from there, you have to take a U-turn because one, you can't drive further because there's no road. If you decide to hike it, you're going to run into Chinese bullets. And so my advice is at Kibitu, take a U-turn. This is Kohima for you in Nagaland. So these are the Apatani tribals in Zero in Arunachal Pradesh, and that's another wonder of India. Fortunately and unfortunately, it's not been infested with tourists yet. It's basically the grandparents' generation mostly who have this knotted hair and tattoos. And here's a little anecdote here, right? So I see this couple walking, and I take the photo, right? And after some time, I post it on Facebook. And this I'm talking about 2010, when Facebook was still not so popular. And after a few months, somebody writes to me. He says, do you mind if I download this photo from Facebook? I said, look, I have no problems, but who are you? And the guy says, you know, this gentleman here is my uncle, who's a local politician. This lady is my mother. And here's the best part. So the good part, the interesting part is, you know, there's somewhere in a remote village, there's a young guy who's on Facebook, which I didn't think he would be, right? And so he connects with me. But the more interesting part was, he says, this is the only photograph I have of my mother, because she's never let us take a photograph of her. I offered to send a high-res one or even a print, but I said, no, this is good for me. So that's a suspension bridge over the River Siang near Pasighat in Arunachal Pradesh. We tried to walk this bridge, which is like a little wobbly, so it was like we were like walking like this. And all the locals, they were wearing broken flip-flops. They were just like running across, like, you know, like goat on mountains, and holding these big baskets of oranges, which grow in the remote villages on the other side of the river. And we had some of those oranges, absolutely organic and sweet, like you cannot, that money cannot buy in Delhi. So these are just some snaps from the book. This is in Arunachal. That's my dancing partner in Zero. She's an Apatani lady. So we danced a lot together. I usually don't dance, but on this occasion, I couldn't say no to this charming lady. Interestingly, you know, like you see these big nose studs and all in these ladies. Do you know why they have them? So the Apatani tribe, the women are supposedly very beautiful. They are actually not supposedly, they are very beautiful, right? But it also meant that they were always in danger of being abducted by the neighboring tribes. So to beat that, they decided to kind of make themselves less beautiful. And they started putting these big nose studs and ear studs and all and stuff and tattooing their faces. That's where the legend goes, right? It's not documented as proof, but that was a deterrent to being abducted. That's a Napatani, that's a cognac headhunter in Nagaland.